With this introduction, I'll be giving over to Rijk from Velvet, who is, for a second time in history, inviting us over. And my main question to you before letting you on stage is that why the hell do you invite us here? So what's in it for you and Velvet?
Really good question. I think the headless experiments what we are doing is really interesting and really like to share it with the community. And I'm like the agency, basically all the startups in Estonia are sharing their stuff, but they like the agencies and studios and smaller like developer communities not sharing. So I think that there's work to be done there, and here we are. And basically it's the only thing I know or try to know. So yeah, the Velvet, the Void thing here, because it's a new venue for us. It's part of Velvet and at the same time it isn't Velvet. We are using it as a like a event venue for us, but it's more as in the near future, it's more like a think tank or something like that to solve bigger problems with bigger clients or without a client, if we can, like with design methodologies and design thinking. But that's a story for another day. There isn't like a pitch for that yet. But if you want to draw on the walls, can ask some markers, and if someone will draw like a WordPress logo here, it would be really cool. So yeah, but I will start my usual thing talking about JavaScript at WordPress meetup. About Velvet, for a second, we are 36 people. It's totally a lie there. I think it's 40 or a bit more. We are. We have the office is there. No tere. Piinlik. Ei tule siis. Our main office is there, but we are also a bit expanding to other places. We are naming it like total design, from service design, strategic design to development, basically whatever. If the problem is a brand or a website or another thing, then we can do it. So yeah, lots of awards and stuff. Cool, cool. Rijk, been at Velvet for 6 years, I think, or seven, six. Came in as a developer from a small agency that I thought that I can run. Nope. And over the years I have been working on like different things in Velvet. That's why Velvet is cool. From design, project management, coding, technical leadership and stuff. Now I'm experimenting and leading the digital team, the design development. Yeah, that's it. The headless thing, I have also already talked about it. It was a bit a popular thing and I had a lot of questions afterwards. So I think I don't know how many were last in the last meetup where we talked about it. So a little reminder, the WordPress what we are used to, or like traditional CMS content management system, is the presentation layer or templating is really tightly coupled with the system, with the database and the structure. So it works, it's totally cool. I'm not here to say that headless is the only way to do things, especially now when I have like published some of them. But I'm not giving up. But the headless thing is like, let's pull the data totally away from the presentation layer. So presentation layer is totally different, or API first content management system. So the because WordPress is really cool, it works. For example, the administration panel editors experience is awesome, and they also have a really cool API for like 2 years, I think 2 or 3 years ago when they released it, it was a mess. But right now, basically every WordPress site has a really cool working API for them, their content. And when decoupling the content from the front end, we can basically use the content everywhere. One of our use cases is, for example, a shopping center has a website with all the stores and their opening times and all the metadata. They need a website, but they also need app. They also need a wayfinding screen, touchscreen on the floor. And if the content will come from the same place, which is familiar for everyone, because WordPress is pretty popular, as you know. So it works really well if you build the data structure the right way. At the same time, you can basically use the same traditional CMS model, because the API is also available here. But usually it's so tightly coupled to the layout and the data structure isn't that good for like front-end agnostic solution. That's my experience. This is the from some of the pluses and minuses from the last time. WordPress database is WordPress database structure. It's a mess, but it's WordPress. The block editor is a really good experience for a user. It works really well for that, but the database, the API response is not structured. The blocks aren't separate. I can't say that I want the second block, or what do I do the image block? So it's basically HTML in one field. So it's a problem. But they're working on it, so it's a standing issue. The ecosystem, all the plugins and stuff, has a really good support for REST API. Like the great plugins, for example, Gravity Forms, or some SA search engine optimization plugins have all an REST API already. So you can use the ecosystem. We can build, for us as a design agency, this is like the main point. We can build our front ends however we want. We are not tied to the strange templating system at this PHP. The administration UI I talked about is cool, and the data is open. Then last time I finished there, and I told that we are experimenting with stuff. Then we did a really one like portfolio website for us, and it's in alpha stage. I need to say it because I'm not really proud of it, but that's how it is. But the technology behind it is cool, and I'm proud of that part. And it's like we are developing it. We are developing it in weekly basis. So the main thing is I will quickly glance over with the data structure for us, because for us, if we started to, it's really straightforward and simple. If you know WordPress. But for us, we started it like as this is an API for our work, our awards, our team. It's not only a back end for our website. It's like, what the hell is portfolio website? What you're doing? But for example, we have 15 years, over 100 awards, and like the portfolio, and we are doing lots of tenders. We need a lot of data all the time, and the producers use it. So basically, who has won the most awards? And it's like the query for something like that. All the portfolio items are linked with team and award, and it's like an API for our work, or what kind of work we did in 2017. So it's like in the front end, there's only few portfolio case studies, but in the back end, it's like a bigger thing. And in the near future, we want to integrate, like, to build a full-blown, like, maybe an archive there as a back-end system, or connected to an intraweb, or basically all it's. But we started from the data, not from the website. It's like, it was the point, and it's hosted in wpp.velvet.de. If you want to look the API, because it's open. Mm-hmm. It's a really cool tool, and we are starting to see that if we are integrating it with other tools we use, for example, we use Toggle for time tracking, or Score for budgeting, or whatever, so we can like connect them somehow, and there are some cool experiments there. So basically, the underlying things are custom post types, and the deeper nested things are taxonomies. Simple, nothing. And WordPress gives us the tools really simply. The interesting part for us, and especially for me, is the front end, because JavaScript is cool. I don't care what you say. And the modern frameworks, what we tested, are these. These are like the most modern thing. They basically do the same thing and at the same time don't. But Next.js is like a React framework. Razzle is for Angular React. It tries to do anything, everything. Nuxt is for Vue. Gatsby is for React. Gatsby is a bit different. They're all of them are really popular. Showcase of their projects are really like Marvel website or Netflix and stuff. So it's like it's pretty much proven software. And they all have the same objective for like the modern web technologies for without the config or really performance optimized, and the server side rendering or statically built. So yeah, we chose the Next.js because they had the most beautiful website. Or whatever, it doesn't really matter. They have the same potato, patata. If you like React, then the next thing is they're really cool. Gatsby is also really cool. Gatsby even has like a because one of the problems here is the previewing of posts. For example, if I have to preview a post in WordPress, you need to like build a really complicated system for that. But Gatsby sells a service for that. They're like rendering all the previews also. So it's a pretty awesome service. Also, Next.js is built by Site, which is a glorified CDN or static host or serverless hosting or whatever they are naming themselves. It's a really cool developer experience. Like, if you want, I know in the room here, most of us are like PHP developers, and the PHP environment and all the pipelines and the servers and stuff. And then you will go to the like JavaScript, modern JavaScript. If you will see past the package.json and NPM installing and all the dependencies, the experience is really awesome. Like basically, for example, every branch in our front end website has like a different URL automatically, and the pipelines are totally built in the service. And the Next and Site hosting works together really well. It's really meta because it's a framework on top of framework, basically. Because React is only a UI interface building library, but we need all the other stuff also, like routing and server-side rendering, the configuration, which is a mess. But Next.js, it works for us. Yeah, that's our stack basically right now. I know that Peter is after me showing some how we did it. So maybe the site thing is there not needed at all. But the data is safe. The WordPress installed on its own. It's on subdomain. It's there. The admins can use it. And the first, if the browser opens the or requests the website, Next.js or let's say site will render the web page on their Node.js server. At the same time, fetching the data from the API, and the browser will get like full HTML rendered HTML. It's really SEO friendly. It will the first time for the loading time is really cool, so really fast. And after that, all the next clicks on the menu and the router will get take it over, and it will the data fetching is right from the WordPress API, so it's really fast because it's only just moving the JSON, basically. So, and this basically difficult or a bit complex thing gives us the total control how to build the interface. And I'm surprised how fast it is. Then this is the slide for you. because maybe too much hours went it for like a simple website. And I have been thinking a lot about it. And it's totally worth it. Maybe not right now financially, because all the things that I have known about WordPress or how I have built WordPress sites, it's like basically cancel that. Yes, I use advanced custom fields still, and the admin is cool and stuff. But basically, right now the purpose. The team building experience is a mess for us. It slows us down. We are writing so much JavaScript already, and we don't want to fight WordPress because we like WordPress, and we don't want to like encapsulate it somewhere else. Be there, be the admin, and we want to build like because, for example, there's some of Velvet designers was also here. Velvet developers, like one of the developers, deliverables what we will get from designer is a video file of the website. Like, yeah, build that also. It's not. It's the, all the interactions, animations are also there, and to do them like in the PHP, JavaScript, like in the framework, it's not the WordPress theming isn't that good for that. It's manageable, but it's. Because for right now we have two repos, Git repositories. The WordPress thing is like 20 commits basically, and all the energy will go to the building the React application. So and the developer experience, I can't say it enough. It's so cool. If maybe it's because we haven't invested a lot of time in like PHP modern stuff. We are still doing the things all the way. We are not using the root Sage stuff or whatever. We are building the using WordPress coding standard and and but like the leap is really big and I will be honest. It helps recruitment, because if you recruit for WordPress team builders versus JavaScript developers are more available. Plus, we have full control of the UI visits, and basically main thing, because we are a design agency, we need to deliver the best experience what we can. And I don't want to say it to a designer, because I don't have time to build it. Because I'm fighting the loop. But yeah, at the same time, WordPress is really cool. WordPress works. I don't want to be a Liar, basically everything that WordPress helps with you. It will not help you anymore. For example, a really stupid thing, but pagination, but you are it's a little function and you can build your pagination, or all the like deep nested category trees or whatever, what purpose renders for you, but you are so accustomed, so you need to build it, that everything yourself. But basically what I have learned that it's like a one time thing that you learn the how to get the data from API. So right now, because it's a the API and the block editor and also the headless thing, it's pretty new for WordPress. It's not the first result in Google anymore, like, because WordPress has so large community. Everything's pretty easy with WordPress because the problem is out there, or the solution for the problem. Right now it isn't. Or there's like basically there is really sketchy plugins. Like one plugin is you can't do a REST API query for, like, for example, a taxonomy query, like what you're doing with in the loop. You like filter posts with that taxonomy and versus or whatever. There's a plugin for that, but the plugin at the same time is selling and it's like selling your data basically. So yeah. Yeah, the hosting issue for our clients, it's bit because right now most of our clients are like on Zone. It's easy. And now you need one website is at Zone. The other thing is at Zite.co. It's awesome. It doesn't. It's not expensive, but it's like to explain it to everything to a client that it needs to be that way. And the website is more complex, but you will get what you want. It's like the leap is a bit bigger because people don't know about the solution what we're doing. Because people are really accustomed to the it's own. I will call better if something is wrong. So yeah, and there aren't a lot of agencies out there who are building it that way. There are developer shops who will know how to build it, but it's more expensive than to just build a regular WordPress team. So there is like a risk for that, but it's changing every time. Mm-hmm. Oh yes, it's moving. In summary, I can share basically all the code if you will send me a mail. I can share. I have all the little snippets. But yeah. You know, need to know JavaScript really well because you're building JavaScript. Pick your tools. The data structure is really important because if you are like getting like an old website and bringing it over as a headless thing, it's more difficult than just starting from like the state new structure. You need to build it like totally agnostic. Of the front end, like you're just building a good database. Don't try to edit the default endpoints and add fields to it. It's easier to write their own custom REST post endpoints, because if you write a custom endpoint, it's basically you write the WebP query and the results will be there and it's totally done. But if you try to edit the endpoint, for example, because WordPress will give you the, for example, we have the portfolio, the project, project's endpoint. It's already by default. If you register a custom post type, you can also build the endpoint. But if you want to like add new fields there, you are fighting the system. It's easier to just do your specific endpoint. What do you need? It's really easy. I started because, for example, the menus isn't in the end. There isn't like default endpoint for that for some strange reason, but WordPress menus are in the like architecture, it's a custom post type or a post type. You can build the endpoint yourself, but I have the experience I have that this plugin works really well. I also we also added like headless CMS fields for it, like a slug or like for routers, like some fields for it. It works. Also, if you're using the advanced custom fields, the advanced custom fields, the REST API plus advanced custom fields, the recursive plugin is lifesaver. And one really silly thing is that you have in the settings site URL and home URL. If you're building a headless website, then the it's home URL, yes. Home URL is, for example, velvet.ee, and the site URL is wp.velvet.ee. But by default, WordPress uses the home URL, and you need to switch it. It's like basically a mistake from them. There's a filter for that. Then also, I have like lots of small, tiny filters and snippets that basically can be a small headless plugin for every bullet project, because it's the same problem over and over again. One of the, like most of the problems what I had was, what I learned that if I would from the start build the endpoints myself, it would be totally easier than to modify it. But the future is really promising. They are building the GraphQL API plugin. I have also in one branch I'm experimenting with, and it works like totally well, but I need to build it all over again. But basically, I don't need to build my own endpoints anymore, because everything is there already. And some of like really popular sites are using it in production, for example, Quartz, the media thing. And it's also the WordPress VIP are allowed plugin or something like that. So it's like production ready, but it's not version one, not yet. But it looks really promising, and maybe it will solve like the growing pains of like building the endpoints. So it needs to look out for that. So yeah, it was a quick overview. If someone has like really specific code questions, I can show it. I don't want to show it here because there's like really broad spectrum of people here. Thanks. I know that Peter has some really cool things to show.
Yes, but I think maybe people first would like to ask you some questions.
Stupid.
So, any questions to Raikon regarding what he has done?
I also like Wim really, like feverishly. But yeah, for us, the React thing is, I really like Vue.js, if I'm totally honest. Angular. We have written some projects because it was the client requirements. But for React, is like the team basically likes React. So it's like a common ground. Let's do it React. Because React is like the, for us, because the team is like really heavily learning JavaScript and investing in it. And React is it's really low level, unopinionated thing to learn then. It's like basically that. Because Vue.js is like a framework, like already with the templating. But the new Vue.js is basically React, so. And Angular is Angular. Don't like cool. Not Facebook at all, also. Don't, so yeah.
A mock editor is written in React, so it makes perfect sense.
Yeah. I'm not really, the technology wise, it isn't that important. Is it React, Nuxt, Next? Whatever, they're all doing the same thing. Pick your tools, because the most interesting thing is for me is the GraphQL API. If I will get that working, it feels like the dream I'm searching. Because the front end thing, It's changing all the time, and I can't see that it will stop like in the near future. And the designers will give us like the next big thing that we need to develop. And we are changing the tools, and we are not like investing React heavily. But the Next.js is a React framework, and so we are doing it right now. But maybe the next project is Nuxt. We are open for it. If or is the maybe the client's requirement is that. Because we are still, we still have clients who say that they want it in Bootstrap, and oh, the conversation is long and heavy, but at final I will build it in Bootstrap.
Why aren't you using GraphQL right now? It's not ready, or
When I started it, it had some issues. I don't remember what were there. Right now because I yesterday I talked with Peter on Slack, and I wrote the presentation. Then I went, oh, I need something in the end. Oh, GraphQL, let's put it there. Oh, it's basically ready. The advanced custom fields plugin is like totally built. But I think the future is basically a mix of the GraphQL and REST API. For example, if I want to use Gravity Forms to post something, I will use REST API for that, and so on. It's like, yeah. But the GraphQL, like for I think like 90% or 80% of the content problems, because it makes sense totally. We use, for example, the SEO plugin. We use SEO framework because it's like really bare bones, low level. Yoast is really full of ads, and they don't have an like endpoint. But their API is really cool. Basically, you can, it's like 20 lines of code, what data you want to put in the field. It's one of the things that I built. But yeah, basically, I see all the problems with if the plugin doesn't have a REST API. It's most of the problems are like, I think that in like few months' time or years' time, it will have, or I will build it's one-time build. It, like, because the data is the same structure. One thing that I'm experimenting, I basically know that it works, is WP, WebML, multilingual stuff. WebML is a story in itself, but basically it works, but the routing will get really difficult. But it basically you need to do it like multiple times, then you will know. Not like WebML is. But WebML has an API, and if you like automatically put the prefix there, like language prefix, it works. So, but yeah, you never know what will happen.
And about SEO once more.
Best.
I heard a lot of like when a coworker of mine actually came to the lab, one of the first things she said was that SEO is a pain in the ass and help us. So.
Who? Who? Merrily. Merrily. Yeah, it's a pain in the ass. It was.
So, like, usually SEO is rendered server side, and then basically we have this application on top of it, as far as my understanding is. Why do we even need SEO or REST of the endpoints for SEO or the actual application?
Because I need the data, for I need the metadata from SEO plugin, for example the keywords or description, or because the interface, it basically the SEO framework plugin will give us the interface, and or like the title builder or open graph meta tags. I basically can like get it from the other data, but it's easier also for our partners. or our clients, the administration panel works.
I'd like to add one more thing, that even when the pages are built on server side, using basically the same code that is used to serve you on the browser side, this code is still running over API. So the server side pages are actually also using API to get data from WordPress and build pages on that.
Yeah, so I need so I need the data somehow.
This needs to be available on API.
Yeah, it's HTML. It's like and the thing that Merily talked because it was the, like the first like bigger problem for us. We are just starting to do the headless stuff, and then oh fuck, but the SEO thing. Google says that he will render it. No, or basically renders it, but it will take time, and it's not the most optimal thing. And
have you seen any actual results related to SEO? Is it bad?
For example, the website. We are not like actively looking at it. Maybe we should.
We need to have somebody who is dealing with SEO but to actually look at Velvet's website and the results and come back with a report.
But
it would be useful also for for you, and it would be making a great talk about how it is, because the myth is about the SEO problems are very common.
But basically, if the if you do a view source on Velvet website, it's HTML. If you if you will do like the view source on like totally regular React thing, then it's like div with a main tag or class, and that's all. But we have like full HTML.
And the comment telling that you need to have JavaScript running.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah. But the client, the user experience. But yeah, for right now, I think that it's totally worth it. If the maybe the Velvet website isn't the best example for a portfolio site. But the next steps, what we are all already looking at, what we want to build on top of it, it's totally worth it, and we are like moving pretty fast. And we are not thinking about we are only thinking about the interface, not thinking about the WordPress. We are it's really maybe the most interesting is that the WordPress is stable, it works, it's there, the data is there, I don't need to think about it, it's auto updated. And frontend is the flaky part. I totally agree. It's a React thing, I don't know what's happening all the time, I'm pretty afraid, but it's a Velvet website, so what can happen. The block editor, the GraphQL basically tries to parse the content and to like build up like totally the block editor scheme. And it was like, whoa! There's also one plugin for REST API who tries to do it. Like to build the components like totally. But in my experience right now, basically because I'm not using the block editor as a layout builder, I'm using it as a block editor for like glorified WYSIWYG. For the for example, the portfolio case studies are like the total block editor, but it's like full HTML. I can like put it there, and I don't need to interact with. And also, I can do it in the client side. I can basically take all the HTML, and it's really performance heavy, but I basically can parse it HTML to React. Yeah, but where to parse it? I want to do everything in the server side, because it makes sense not to parse it on the client side to the HTML to React. So, but I know that there's a the WordPress core team has a like issue up, and they are working on it, how to put the block editor metadata back to REST API, because the block editor does it. Yeah, but it's a as we know, it's like WordPress is has a lot of legacy problems, and they're trying to move really fast. And I basically agree how they did the block editor thing, that they like published the alpha thing in the works and let's see what will happen. And they are iterating really quickly. They're not for us it works.
Are you guys using any React UI library?
No. Yes, this project is really interesting. For me, it was like, okay, headless WordPress, Next.js, totally new thing. React was totally new thing for me because I was in the Vue guy. Then I also thought, okay, let's do it like full blown. Then let's forget the SAS and like styling thing. Let's put Tailwind on top of it. And then basically it's like full of experiments. It's like. Only thing is the post CSS and Tailwind, and it also really positive experience.
Are you also loading your content code into Docker, or with the week kind of becomes more of a content experience?
Not yet. And
that's what I'm working on. I'm trying to get web components loaded.
Maybe when they like the bigger thing is that they're trying to build all the admin in React, maybe it's like will get better and better. But yeah, for example, building on for a block editor is totally full of boilerplate stuff. It's like it's not that easy as it looks. One thing I forgot, so it's not one thing. Our website.
Yeah. can you access to your Google Analytics account for
Google? No, but I can basically you can write to me. I can show you, but we are not doing active SEO on our site.
Yeah, I see.
but the problem what we are trying to solve isn't the SEO problem. We are trying to solve like building great user experiences problem. That's like our main focus. But the level of what we want from the framework, we have like full HTML rendered for the bots and the crawlers. That's what I want. And if I want to build our SEO thing there on top of it, or do like a real thing, then it's the possibility. The React, the headless thing, isn't half-assed SEO thing anymore. It works. That's our like sort of. But awesome! Can you show me later? You have antivirus. This is like the I want to show you that. But yeah, it's really interesting. It's like one of the first. Usually it's the links doesn't work or something like that.
But yeah, I'd really like if some SEO and things like analytics people would join in on Velvet, and because there is probably they are kind of the only one who's, because I think the question of I was showing earlier, the Osco and Sotka. Probably we can't get the hands to the Osco and Sotka SEO material.
But so I think they have thought about it.
Yeah. So, or maybe we can ask. You can always ask and see what happens. Any more questions? Or we'll switch to me. There is also a question that I originally wrote that maybe we'll make a short networking break between me and Raik. But considering the seating here is pretty compact, maybe it's easier if I'm doing my presentation also in a row. Or do you want to walk around in a bit? How's your feeling? Which way? Put me on stage or put pizza on stage? Pizza. Yeah, so we can... Yeah, you just need to be... Yeah. Who wants to have a short pizza and beer break? And who wants to? Okay, these want. And who wants to go on with the next presentation? More. Okay, let's go on more and then do that. You probably don't want to exercise yourself.
Okay.
So.
Thanks.
Okay. Thanks. Thanks, Drake.